In the previous video, whose title is Photoelectric Effect 1, we discussed the conditions of photoelectric effect. Now let's continue our study about this phenomenon. Each electron inside the atom interacts with the nucleus, with the other electrons in the atom, and with the other atoms in the metal. So the electron cannot leave the atom spontaneously. Then the work function W0 of a metal is the minimum energy needed to extract an electron from the surface of this metal. W0 is characteristic of this metal. This table shows the work function of some metals. EV stands for the electron volt, which is a unit of energy. 1 EV equals 1.602 times 10 to the power minus 19 joules.
In 1902, Philip Lennard did an experiment on photoelectric effect. This experiment supports the failure of the classical wave model of light in explaining the photoelectric effect. Let's discuss the contradiction between the classical wave model and the experimental results. When light is incident on the surface of a metal, we predict from the classical wave model that if the light intensity or the power is sufficiently high, electrons are liberated, whatever the frequency of the incident light. Now, let's move to the experimental results. A green light is incident on this metal. We increase the intensity of this light. Even though the intensity is increased, no electrons are liberated from the surface of the metal. But why? Electrons are not liberated when the wavelength of the incident light is greater than the threshold wavelength of this metal, regardless of the light intensity.
Now, let's give another contradiction. As the light intensity or power incident on a metal increases, electrons should be ejected with more kinetic energy, since the energy is proportional to the average power. But according to the experimental result, using this PHAT simulation, as the intensity or the power of the incident light increases, the speed or the kinetic energy of each electron does not change. So the kinetic energy does not depend on the power or the intensity of the incident light. Only more electrons are liberated when we increase the power.
Another contradiction between the classical wave model and the experimental results. At low light intensities, the photoelectrons need a measurable time interval to absorb energy before they acquire enough kinetic energy to escape from the metal. Now, observe the experimental results. The electrons are liberated almost instantly from the surface of the metal, even at very low intensity. The photoelectrons are emitted from the surface of the metal in less than 10 power minus 9 seconds, even at very low light intensities.
In 1900, Planck announced his hypothesis of the quantization of energy in order to explain the phenomenon of black body radiation. Planck postulated that matter could absorb or emit radiant energy only in specific values. This energy is called quantized. Let's take two examples. The ice cream absorbs quantized radiant energy and melts. In this example, a cup containing hot tea emits quantized radiant energy and its temperature decreases. The meaning of quantized will be explained in the next slide.
Quantized energy is the energy having only certain discrete values and not a continuous set of values. For example, currency is quantized. In US currency, the coin of least value is the cent or the penny whose value is $0.01. Only greater amounts of currency are of the form n times $0.01, where n is always a positive integer. For example, you cannot hand someone 5.5 cents. Now, this girl moves down a slide of length 3 meters. The distance traveled by the girl on the slide takes all the possible values between 0 and 3 meters. So, the values of this distance are not quantized.
The metal spoon is placed in sunlight. It receives radiant energy from the sun. Now, according to Planck's hypothesis, the amount of light energy transferred to the spoon is quantized, which means that it is equal to a whole number multiple of a smallest unit of energy called the quantum. The quantum is the smallest amount of energy that a wavelength of light can possess. The plural of quantum is quanta. Then the radiant energy absorbed or emitted by matter is given by n times h times nu. N is a non-zero positive whole number. H is called the Planck's constant. In SI, H equals 6.626 times 10 to the power minus 34 joules times second. Nu is the frequency of the electromagnetic radiation. In SI, nu is expressed in hertz.
Focus, please. This is important.
In the year 1900, Planck announced that matter absorbs or emits quantized radiant energy. In 1905, Einstein suggested that light itself is quantized, which means that light could be considered a particle or a quantum of energy. This is Einstein's hypothesis of light quanta. A radiation of a frequency nu consists of small packages of energy called quanta. In 1926, the chemist Gilbert Lewis introduced the term photon to describe a quantum of light. A photon is an uncharged particle of zero mass. It moves in vacuum at the speed of light c, which is equal to 3 times 10 to the power 8 meters per second. The energy of one photon is h times nu. Nu equals c over lambda, as you know. Now, what if we have a beam of light? What is the total energy of a light consisting of n photons? This energy equals the number of the photons times the energy of one photon, which is equal to n h nu.
In photoelectric effect, one incident photon may interact only with one electron, which is called one-to-one interaction.
In the previous episode, we have seen that in order to extract electrons from the surface of a pure metal, the frequency of the incident light should be greater than or equal to the threshold or the cutoff frequency of this metal. Now, let's relate the emission of electrons to the work function of the metal, and of course, we will use the one-to-one interaction. Consider this metal. Red light is incident on this metal. There is no emission of electrons. Let's increase the power or the intensity of red light. Again, there is no emission of electrons, but why? The energy of each photon in the red light is less than the work function of this metal. Then, there is no emission of electrons. Now, blue light is incident on this metal. The energy of each photon in the blue light is greater than that of a photon in the red light. Now we have emission of electrons. But why? The energy of each photon in the blue light is greater than the work function of the metal. Then electrons are liberated from the surface of this metal. What can we conclude from this study? Whatever the power of the incident radiation, an electron is not ejected from the metal surface unless it absorbs a photon whose energy is equal to or greater than the work function of this metal. Finally, the phenomenon of photoelectric effect supports or confirms the corpuscular or the particle model of light.
In the previous episode, we relate the emission of electrons to the threshold or cutoff frequency. In this episode, we relate the emission of electrons to the work function. Actually, the condition of the frequency leads to the condition of the work function. Let me explain this. If the frequency of an incident photon nu is less than the threshold or the cutoff frequency nu zero of a metal, then h nu must be less than h nu zero. But h nu is the energy of the photon, and h nu zero is the work function of the metal. Since a photon is less than w zero, then The electron is not liberated from the metal.
Now, if the frequency of the incident photon equals the threshold frequency of this metal, then h nu equals h nu zero, then the energy of the photon is exactly equal to the work function of this metal. In this case, the photon might be absorbed. If the electron absorbs this photon, it will use all the energy of the photon to liberate from the surface of the metal. Then it is liberated at a zero speed.
Finally, if the frequency nu of an incident photon is greater than the cutoff frequency nu zero of a metal, then h nu is greater than h nu zero, or the energy of this photon is greater than the work function of the metal. This photon might be absorbed. When an electron absorbs this photon, it is ejected from the surface of the metal with a non-zero speed.
When a metal is exposed to a suitable radiation, the least tightly bound electrons require the least energy, W0, to liberate from the metal. Therefore, these photoelectrons leave with maximum kinetic energy, Ke max. The energy of the absorbed photon is the sum of the work function W0 of this metal and the maximum kinetic energy of the liberated electron. This is Einstein's photoelectric equation.